tutorial, we want to present a new, exciting and very much demanded feature, which is multi-language. This makes life so much easier because you no longer have to duplicate skin elements or entire projects to have one tour for every language that your audience speaks. Instead, thanks to our language editor that we created in VT Pro, the tool will detect where your user comes from and will show the respective texts like buttons, stickers, info windows, etc. in his or her own language. That means you will only have one virtual tour project, which saves you a lot of work and hosting space. Here's how. So once we've created our tour in what usually is our own language, with its skin, stickers, buttons, etc., we go to the Publish tab. And in there, we go to the new tab called Language. And in here, we manage all the text that our tour contains, as well as their translations. As you can see, right now, we only have one language, which is English, the one we used to put together our original virtual tour. And that's, so to say, our default language. With a double click on it, we can edit that. There's a long list of languages. And we can even, within one language, narrow it down to, say, British or American English, but that's optional. Alright, so here we have all the text elements that our tour contains, divided by categories. This is the title of the tour. Inside this skin category, we have everything separated by type. This, for instance, would be all the multiline texts that our skin contains. And the different colors here mean that the white text refers to your texts in the desktop tour version, while the blue one refers to the mobile tour version. So if you are using our recently introduced dual skin feature, you know that you are optimizing your tour for every device, and for mobile devices it usually makes sense to cut texts down to a minimum. So that's why there are different text versions depending on the device. And you obviously want to translate both versions, and by way of different colors, you can easily distinguish them. If you have a look in our skin, we do have a general skin and a mobile skin, and you can see in here that some of the texts are much more confined. So instead of panorama list, it just says panoramas to save space. Okay, going back to where we were, so we have our multiline texts, we have our label elements, we have the texts or names of all of our buttons. And all this appears here automatically. So every time you create or place a text element in your tour, it'll appear here for you to manage and translate. The same goes for our media. So we have our panorama titles here, the titles of the videos. And finally, for our hotspots, where we have the text of all of our tooltips. Now to translate all of this, we add a new language by clicking on the plus icon and selecting our language. Let's take Spanish. And again, we could also define which Spanish, so South American countries or for Spain, but in our case we're gonna leave it just with Spanish. Now that is set up, but we are still in the English language tab, so click on Spanish and now we can start making our changes with this side-by-side view. When you see this red icon, it means that the translated version has not been modified yet. So this is a great little helper when we have a long list of texts, so we don't get lost and find right away where we were and which parts we haven't touched or paid attention to yet. And now it's basically just inserting the texts as you want them in the Spanish version. Okay, as you can see, once I change the text, the red icon disappears. And that is how we go through all of the texts now. With this longer text, to speed things up, I'll just pop that into Google Translate, though it's obviously recommended to double check the translation, or ideally use original texts or proper translation programs. And don't forget to also translate the blue mobile texts. As you can see, the texts are very well structured and organized, so you can go through them step by step and edit them. Up here, we can of course add as many language versions as we want, and we can also delete the existing language version by clicking on the X. So that's how we would create a new language version going through the tour text by text. But there's a second option, which might be more comfortable if you have a lot of text, for example. And that is this button down here, which exports your texts as one single file, which you can then give to a translator or run through a program, and then import the translated file using the second button. So you click export and select where you want to save it to, and it would create one file for each language that we established in the tabs. In the format .po, which is pretty standard for text editing or also for more specialized translation programs such as PoEdit, which happens to have a free version too. And then we would simply import that translated version. So there's two ways of doing this. And once we translated all texts, we publish or preview. And depending on where we are, our browser detects our language and opens the tour with the corresponding language. So if I'm in the UK and my browser is English, well, it'll show the English texts. Whereas if I am in Spain with a Spanish browser, it would automatically show the Spanish texts in the tour. Another cool way to offer multi-language to your audience is to actually give the choice of language to the user. So to add a language button down here, for instance, where they can switch between Spanish and English. For that, we also added a new function, which is this one. First, we need the icons, which I have already prepared. Select one of the icons and click Add Action to actually make this icon a button that does something. And now we scroll down to this newly added function, which we developed just for this purpose, Change Language. Now here we see all the languages that we created in our language tab. So as we add more languages, they will start appearing here automatically too. Right, for the Spanish button, we select Spanish texts. And for the English one, English. Let's try. And indeed, it starts off with the automatically detected language, but lets me switch to Spanish and back to English and changes the button respectively. All this information, the panorama titles, and any text that we have in our project. And that's it. We hope that you like this new addition and that it helps you reach an even bigger audience with tours that are tailored to them no matter where they come from. We think it's a great feature that allows you to optimize your tours, but with the minimum complexity and all below the same umbrella of one single virtual tour project and link. Thanks for watching!